Today, together with us is our very special invited guest, and that is Dr. Azizah Abujidan from University of Science Malaysia. She has been here with us for the past 2 days, together with us with our e-learning award ceremony and MOOC seminar 2018. And we'd like to take this opportunity to have a short interview with Dr. Azizah. Dr. Azizah, welcome and thank you for coming to share with us your knowledge and your experiences with all of our fellow colleagues in UMS.
Thank you for having me here.
Thank you. We'd like to ask you, for example, in this 1 week, we understand that you have 5 different appointments in 5 different states moving around. So what is, and you are there to share, to help establish all the academicians. Okay. What is your passion and what is it that motivates you to do what you are doing?
Okay, so thank you, Prof. I think that I love teaching. The main thing about me is I really love teaching, because I think that, you know, from teaching, you can learn as well. Okay, being a teacher, you are learning while you are giving. All right, so it is hard, okay, to, you know, go around, okay, and move around to share your expertise or share your experience with others. But with passion and, you know, with what I have in mind is I want to learn. I would like to learn from people. I share because I would like to learn from others. Because, you know, when you go from place to place, you see different people, they are experts in their area, okay, but they don't know, they might not know how to establish themselves towards, you know, more and more exposure to others. All right, so I come to you know, I go to different universities, different places, because I think that I can share how I establish myself. And I share my passion in teaching, in sharing to others. Because, you know, some of the people, they have this expertise, but they don't know how to share. All right? They are working in silo. They are working by themselves without knowing that they have this potential to share with others. All right? So that's why sometimes we see the academics have been there for so many years, but they don't know where to go. So I'm here to help them, you know, to assist them or to facilitate them to go beyond what they are now. Okay, I think that that is important, because I think that I've been here. I am here now because I have mentors that helped me before to establish myself. That they show me how to go beyond what I was before. So, you know, so people need mentoring. And sometimes we don't know. So I'm here to help people because I have been helped by others before this. Okay. That is actually motivates me to do what I'm doing right now.
Yes, wonderful. So your motivation, your passion is occupying a lot of your time.
Yes.
So how do you manage your time before other affairs?
Okay, so time management, okay. My husband always said, okay, you should say no. But, you know, you should say no. But, you know, in my heart, because I am a very passionate in teaching. So when people ask me, can you do this? Can you help us to, you know, give talk or whatever, sharing session with academics? Sometimes I say, okay, I cannot say no. And now my husband understand me. Okay. Actually, it is family. Okay. Family support is the most important thing in your life. Okay, without family support, you cannot go anywhere. Right? As a woman, you know, it is important that you have your husband's support or whatever, your partner's support. All right, and as well as your children's support, it is important, because without their support, you are like VC of your SM said, they will clip your wings. Okay, in one of the videos of VC, Prof. Asma, from Dato' Asma, she did mention that if your husband do not support you, they will clip your wings. So you cannot fly anywhere. All right. So I now I am in that place. You know, if my husband clip my wings, I cannot go anywhere. And as a Muslim, you know, you should follow your husband. You must follow what your husband said. So now my husband is a very understanding man. He know what my passion is. You know, I always share what I'm doing with him. All right. And I always get his opinion on what I do. So, you know, that particular support is actually motivates me. Okay. My husband is he understand what I'm doing. And he always encourage me, okay? Sometimes you should do this. You should do like this. And that, you know, is something that I think will help women especially to get a work-life balance. Without that support, I don't think I'll be here today. I'm here, you know, as a AAN winner. Because, you know, if not, I cannot go anywhere. Yes.
Indeed, I understand what you're saying. Dr. Ajita, that what you are today is indeed a family affair.
Yes, definitely, bro. Definitely.
And even more, you're a wonderful testimony, actually, you and your husband.
Yeah.
A wonderful testimony of the power of helping one another.
Yes.
As a couple.
Yes.
And the meaning of synergy.
Yeah.
And collaboration and cooperation.
Yes. I think my husband support me so much because he is an IT officer, so he helped me a lot in terms of technology because I haven't got time to review technology and so on. So he always suggested to me, try this one, try this apps because, you know, it can help you with your teaching and so on. So I learned a lot from him. Oh,
yes,
yeah.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
And how about time management for your children?
Ah, okay. Yes, they help me actually.
Oh,
my children help me. Yeah, they, you know, in terms of, you know, as a mom, you know, you need to, you know, because you need to get your children to be independent. All right, very independent. If they rely on you too much, they won't be independent. So even my youngest daughter, 8 years old, okay. So she's already independent. She already know that her mom always go here and there, and she know how to take care of herself. All right. So and she, although she is quite manja, but you know she can take care of herself. All right. So you know, meaning that you educate, you get your children to be independent, okay, and try to be. To help you in the task, meaning that you educate your children. That is important. And they can understand you.
Right.
Yeah.
Wonderful, wonderful. Wonderful time management.
Yeah.
Dr. Ajita, since you received the very prestigious award, the Anugerah Academic Negara in 2017, you have been invited to many places and you have been sharing and speaking before very high level people, you know, to rectors, to vice chancellors, and so on. Now, and I see you to be someone who is full of confidence when you speak before the crowd. So I was wondering, is there any sense of fear within you? Are you a super lady?
No,
I'm a super woman to me.
Yeah.
No, I'm not a super lady. Okay, I have fear. I have, you know. I think that sometimes I am lack of confidence, you know. Sometimes, you know, I feel that, okay, I cannot do this, but, you know, I have to do it, okay? You know, sometimes when I've been invited to various places and so on, you know, when I see, okay, the VC is there, okay, and I was like, okay, I am just Azida. And I have to speak in front of the VC, and I was actually scared. Okay, I was actually scared. But, you know, but I have to do it because, you know, if I don't do it, I cannot see what I would like to deliver to the audience, to other people, because I like sharing. Okay, so I have to get used to it. So at first, I was scared, but I go and do it. Just do it. You know, you have to do it. You have to get yourself feel confident. Yes, everybody will have their inferiority. You know, you have the problem in having yourself to start with something. Okay. Sometimes, you know, everybody, you know, me, although I've been teaching for like 10 years, more than 10 years, okay, every time I go to class, I have this small inferiority in myself. Okay, I say, okay, maybe they know more than me. Okay, this is our lack of confidence. But I just go. Okay, just go and do it. Okay, don't let that particular unconfident let you down.
Yes.
That is important because, you know, everybody has it. Okay, you must remember everybody has the unconfident thingy in their, you know, as a human. As a human, that is normal. That is normal, but you have to go and do it.
Yes,
yeah.
Indeed.
Yeah.
So when there's fear, many people run away. But when we approach and face-to-face approach the fear, the fear will shrink.
Yes.
Yeah. And Dr. Ajida, how would you sum up yourself in one tagline concerning who you really are?
Okay. So, I would say I am a very passionate teacher. Okay. I am a very passionate teacher and I love sharing. So, you know, I love to share and, you know, you just can approach me and I will share anything that I know. Okay. So, yes, I'm very passionate in sharing everything that I know.
Yes.
And I also like to learn.
Yes.
Yeah. Mature.
Memang Dr. Ajida is a person who is very accommodating.